Hare Krishna. Again back speaking about the glories of Bhagavad Gita as it is. Bhagavad Gita means song of God, which was sung by Lord Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So you may be wondering, how is that Krishna was singing a song in the battlefield? Though it is said it is a song of God, but actually it is a conversation between Lord Krishna and his friend and devotee, Arjun. So Arjun is asking question and Lord Krishna is giving answers. As you know that there is a family who is known as Kuru Vanshi, the descendant of King Kuru, and now they have a fraction. Now there are two parts. One family is known as Kauravs and one is known as Pandavs. There are five Pandava brothers. They are very righteous. They are fighting for the right cause. And there is another party who is headed by Duryodhan, who is a gang leader, and he is occupying the throne of Hastinapur by illegal means, and he told to the Pandavas, if you want to occupy the throne, then fight with me. So the Pandavas, they tried their best, even they sent Lord Krishna as a peace messenger, but nothing happened, all in vain. So it is said that when good arguments fail, then violence is necessary. So now they are on the battlefield and situation is very tense. There are two armies on the both sides, and Arjuna, as he directed to Lord Krishna, take my chariot in the middle of these two armies. And knowingly, Krishna took the chariot in front of his gurus, his seniors like Dronacharya and Bhishma, grandfather Bhishma. So when Arjuna saw them, his heart was filled up with compassion and he thought it is not a good idea to fight with them, and he declined to fight. So this is the background of Bhagavad Gita. Because he is a warrior, it is his duty to fight, but he is refusing. So Krishna thought he is an appropriate candidate to be enlightened with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Actually, Arjun, the devotee of Lord Krishna, he is an eternal devotee of Lord Krishna. He can never be illusioned, but he is pretending as if he is confused about his duty. So Krishna has taken the opportunity, using him, to disseminate this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So now there are two armies on both sides and Arjun is in the middle. Drums have been beaten and conches have been blown already. They are ready for fight. So Krishna is giving him this timeless message. So do you think that Krishna was singing Bhagavad Gita? For example, Shri Bhagavanu Vacha Urdhav Moolam Adha Shakham Ashvatham Prahur Avvayam Chandasi Yasya Aparnani Yastam Ved Saved Vit. You think Krishna was singing when situation was so tense? So no. Actually, it was a dialogue between them. Arjuna is asking questions and Krishna is replying with a great speed. So now here we go to Bhagavad Gita. For example, here is the original verse in the Sanskrit language. Chapter 9, the most confidential knowledge. Ananyas चिन्त्यन्तो माम ये जनः परियुपासते तेषां नित्याभियुक्तानां योगक्षेम वहाम्यहम्। So that is the verse spoken by Krishna. Actually, as I told you, it was a conversation, it was a dialogue between Lord Krishna and Arjun. So Maharishi Vedvyas, who is compiler, writer, author of the Bhagavad Gita, he is the one who put these verses into chapter and into nice singable Sanskrit. So now the verses have been divided into 18 chapters and altogether 700 verses. So there is a original Sanskrit verse and then there is a Roman transliteration. The same verse which is in Sanskrit, now it is written in Roman, in English. And then there is a word to word meaning. And then not only that, then there is a translation of the verse. So this is the translation of this verse, text number 22, chapter 9. But those who worship me with devotion, meditating on my transcendental form, to them I carry what they lack and preserve what they have. So this is the translation of that verse. So sometimes what happens, even we read the translation, we may not really grasp the meaning of that verse. So mercifully, Acharya Swami A.C. Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada, he has given a purport, commentary. He has expanded the meaning more. So here is a purport. So that makes the book very authentic. So there is a original Sanskrit verse, then Roman transliteration, then word-to-word meaning, then translation, and then purport, commentary. So in this way, this book has become very glorious. So this is known as Bhagavad Gita as it is. So remember, there is a verse, then there is a Roman transliteration, then word-to-word meaning, and translation, and commentary. So we can see the book has become like this size. Let me see how many pages. There are almost 900. Oh boy, let me count. 981. So there are 981 pages. So now we understand why Gita is so big. Actually, Gita can come in a very small size. I have seen actually Bhagavad Gita very little. So little that people, they put in the locket and put around their necklace or whatever, neck bead. Little Bhagavad Gita with original Sanskrit verses. But it is expanded because there is a word-to-word meaning and commentary, etc. So that's why we can say that it was not really sung by Krishna. It was a dialogue and it was happening very quickly because both armies were ready to fight. So some devotee, they say that it must have taken to Krishna and Arjuna less than 1 hour. Some say 45 minutes. But we can imagine that it did not take a great length of time because they were ready to fight and Arjuna had some doubt in the mind and Krishna was clearing those doubts. So it must have happened in a short period. And then after hearing Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was ready to fight and battle started. So that is the another glories of Bhagavad Gita. Thank you. Hare.